we are enjoying this unfolding, and we are enjoying the response of the group to this unfolding. And there is so much richness and value that we can mine together. Do you want to?
I'm willing to listen. I'm willing to do the work.
So let's just begin by saying to you that maybe the easiest way for you to hear it is that your life is happening to you at many levels of your awareness. So there are the things that you are aware of that you want, and there are things that you are aware that people are aware of you. In other words, there's your awareness of what you want, and your awareness of what that person's opinion of what you want is, and that person's opinion of what you want is. In other words, there are so many awarenesses going on, all revolving around you, really, around any one of you. So you are describing to us some practices of what we have been calling deliberate creation. We've had lots of conversations with lots of people over the years about exactly what you're talking about, how to get what you want, to think about it, to focus on it, to don't think contradictory thoughts about it, and watch the universe yield it. This is just law of attraction 101. This is just how law of attraction works. But there is also, and we really talked about it a lot here today, there's the awareness that you are an extension of source energy, and that source energy is holding intentions that you brought with you when you came into this body, and that you've honed from this physical life experience. And one of those intentions is you are a teacher to the very core of your being. And you understand that you can't teach with words. Words really don't mean very much. That you teach through the clarity of your example. And so through the clarity of your example, those who are ready to receive what you are exampling can receive the benefit of it. So now, here we are having a conversation with a lot of people who are learning about deliberate creation. And some of them are really at the place where they're working on some Adele tickets, or they're working on a new mate, they're working on something. And so to hear someone describe the unfolding in a way that makes their heart sing is very beneficial to them. But then it's like, and this happened, and this happened, and this happened, and this happened. And I'm riding the wave of all of that good stuff happening, because while the intentions didn't originate from my observation of something, they originated from a conversation with someone. Eventually, I started manifesting things that then I began to parlay into more things, and into more things, and into more things, and into more things. And then eventually, something that I really wanted did not come about. How is this possible? Abraham, am I a deliberate creation or am I not? The answer is, you are a deliberate creator and better at some things than others. You have more resistance within you on some subjects than others. On some subjects that you hold no resistance, things come easily. Those Adele tickets were a primary example of that. You had no resistance. You got activated through a conversation. It doesn't matter how it came about. That desire was activated within you. And because you had no resistance, the universe just yielded it to you. Not so that you could show off, not so that you could best somebody else, not because you're in any sort of competition, but because that's how it works. And so as you identify and isolate and notice the emotional components that go along with the focused components, then you come away with something that you understand. But there is a tendency to look into the manifestations for all of the answers. And that's what's tripping you up. It's almost what trips everybody up, because manifestations hardly ever hold. In other words, if you get all excited about this whatever success that you had, and that's what you give most of your undivided attention to, you're not feeding the pipeline for the things that are coming next and next and next and next and next and next and next. And there's a continual barrage of those, because nothing that you've ever created is going to stand and sustain itself. There have to be more creations in the pipeline. Your juices have to continue to flow. The way that we can speak that to you simply is someone will say to us, Abraham, I've written a magnificent book and it flowed through me and I could feel it's inspired and it's just the best book and people are going to love it, but I can't get anybody to publish it and I'm not making any money with it yet. What should I do? And we say, write another book. Well, they don't want to write another book. They want to ride this pony further, 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 further. We say, write another book. You got to keep the juices flowing, because it's the juices flowing that keep you in that place of receptiveness where you can know what your guidance is telling you and whether this impulse is something that will serve you in a positive way or will be something that will cause a negative manifestation. So now, we know we've said a lot. We're going to bring this round where it can begin to make some sense to you. So we know for sure that you know how the laws of the universe work. And when you were thinking about something to which you had no resistance, you just applied them simply and it manifested. And even your braggadocious behavior afterward was not out of sync, because that was all part of the same manifestation. In other words, Esther was about beside herself when they played what they thought was the wrong cue, when it was something that she'd been planning before she came out. That was a manifestation that was so satisfying to her, even though it was only a manifestation that was about maybe 32 seconds long in coming. It still was pleasing. So it doesn't matter how long you've been thinking about things, the universe can yield to you. The factor that is the most significant is, how much resistance do I have going on? And the simple fact of the universe is, you have way more resistance going on relative to a relationship than you do relative to some tickets that you didn't really even want or know about. Now, this is the part that is so interesting and really juicy, really satisfying, really something to sink our teeth into. Don't get too excited, because you're not going to like it. No. That's right. Is that even though you do know how it works, and even though you often demonstrate it for yourself, you still fell back into a lackful mode, almost a whiny, complaining mode. And we don't blame you, because when you're not getting something you want, when you feel disappointed, you're disappointed. When something that you thought that you wanted came and then it didn't stick around, we understand that feeling of disappointment. But then you forgot everything you know about the laws of the universe. And you began, just in your conversation with us, plunking all kinds of engines down on the train. So here you are talking with infinite intelligence. We know this stuff. We can convey it to you through words, because we don't have any life experience that you can watch. Esther live some life experience that we can set forth as some example, and you do too. But what's really interesting is that as we're visiting with you after the demonstration of the engine going toward desire and the engine going in opposition, still with all of that knowing, still the momentum that you had going on that subject was to plunk another engine down and another engine down and another engine down and not really be aware that you were doing it. And this is why. It's because manifestations feel real and like they should be talked about. You feel as humans like you should objectify anything that is reality, and the reality should be examined. And that is your downfall, because when you examine the components of reality that are not pleasing you, you practice a vibrational momentum that makes it easy for you to get something that you don't care about and difficult for you to get something that you do care about, because what you do care about you've thought about with resistant. So much so that even though you're sitting here, you know our deal. You know what we want to hear from you. You know the words that we are looking forward to hearing from you. And yet, once you got on that sort of rampage of disappointment, you could hardly stop yourself, because that's where the momentum is.